You are listening to the audio original production of Tortoise and Hare Decluttering by Dana K. White.
This is part of a series of one-hour unscripted audio products we're calling Decluttering Deep Dives. I'm tackling topics that trip people up when they declutter. I've taught my process for getting and keeping your home under control in my books, Organizing for the Rest of Us, Decluttering at the Speed of Life, and How to Manage Your Home Without Losing Your Mind. These Decluttering Deep Dives are not a book. They're conversations on common decluttering struggles that I hear from people all the time. I'm calling this one Tortoise and Hare Decluttering, Why Almost Everyone Resists, but Shouldn't Resist, the Take It There Now strategy. So what is the Take It There Now strategy? It is the key to my no-mess decluttering process. Basically, how it works is, as you take something out of the space that you are decluttering, you deal with it. You completely, totally deal with each item as you remove it from the space, meaning you make a final decision and then you act on that final decision about that one item. So there's no keep box, there are no piles, there's no pulling everything out of a space to get started decluttering. You just do one item at a time. And that's the reason that my no-mess decluttering process works. So let's talk about the tortoise and the hare story. You know the story, right? Like, it's one of those stories that my mom told me. I heard it in school. I read books. I saw cartoons. I've told it to my own kids over and over and over again for lots of reasons, you know, because they needed to hear the story. So the basic story is that the hare and the tortoise race each other. A hare is basically like a rabbit, but it's not a rabbit. A tortoise looks a lot like a turtle, but it's not a turtle, right? So there's the tortoise and the hare. And in this story, the picture that I have in my head, I'm pretty sure is from a children's book that I read when I was a child. And in this picture, you see the hare and the tortoise at the beginning of the race. The hare is yellow. Not that that matters, but, you know, I'm all about those irrelevant details. So the hare is the one that everybody assumes is going to win, right? Like, everybody is cheering for the hare, and nobody even really considers the tortoise. Because how in the world could the tortoise win a race against the hare? But the basic story is that the hare wears himself out, does kind of crazy things, gets distracted, and ends up losing the race because the tortoise just kept walking. So at the beginning of the race, the hare races off and everybody's cheering for the hare. And you look back and you don't even realize the tortoise has actually taken a step because it looks like they're still at the starting line. Like, it doesn't even seem like this is an actual race. But in the end, the tortoise wins. But y'all, I know the story. I've told the story. I understand the point of the story. Slow and steady wins the race. I get it, y'all. It's a basic life principle. But I still want to be the hare. I don't want to be the tortoise, right? Because everybody cheers for the hare. Everybody's excited about the hare. I mean, as long as we're talking about racing, let me just take a moment to tell you something. If you don't have kids yet, or if your kids aren't there, or maybe this is just a memory for you, but if you've ever been to a track meet, the 100-meter stuff, that's exciting. It's fun to cheer for the 100-meter races. You can cheer the whole entire time. But when your kid runs the mile, it's just not that exciting. Because you cheer a little bit, and then you're like, this is awkward. They're all the way on the other end. Okay. All right. Okay, they're back. Yay. Okay. And it just keeps going and going. Y'all, the most devoted parents go to cross-country races, right? They're not that exciting. I want to be the hare, and yet it's the tortoise who wins. So I just want to clarify before I get into my analogy here that decluttering is not a competition. There are no winners or losers comparatively. But if you declutter, you win. Okay, so let's don't get too caught up in the comparison, but I do want to talk about the reality of how we want to run this race, how we want to start it. So here's my short story. I used to tackle decluttering as a big all or nothing project. I would throw myself into it with lots of energy in the beginning. I would pull everything out of the space because I thought that was what I had to do to declutter, because that's what most people will tell you you have to do when you declutter. And then I would fizzle. And I would have stuff that used to be shoved in a closet now out over the counter or my floor or in the hallway. And things were worse than they were before, and it made me discouraged, and it kept me from making real progress, because then those piles outside would either drift out into the rest of the house, or I would get frustrated, just shove them back into the space that I was originally working on. And now they were just a huge jumble, instead of kind of having a little bit of understanding of where things were within that space. So that never worked for me, but real change came in my home when I just started getting stuff out, one by one, item by item, no matter how slowly. And I stopped trying to do things in a frenzy, and I just slowly got stuff out of my house. Y'all, it's not exciting to say, but I'm the tortoise. My no-mess decluttering method is...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.